All right, hello everybody, and welcome to a. This is going to be kind of an odd video, for me to do because my headset is just, it's. So I'm going to be. Hopefully, you can hear me all right. I'd imagine you can, because the microphone still works. But we're going to take a look at the new development blog here on the War Thunder website on another Dagger Engine 5.0. Improvement. So we've already looked at a few of these they've had over the course of the past couple weeks. If we scroll down here past all the spoilers, here's some other ones that they did. These are some of the other ones already taken a look at, including things like temporal anti-aliasing coming to the game, which is going to make edges look a lot less jaggedy and a lot less of the what is that? That people are saying the flickering in bushes and stuff. So hopefully that's good. We have a blank page here. That's always good too. And then we've got weather and environment, like rain is getting reworked, fog is getting reworked, clouds and sun are getting reworked. They're now going to be more dynamic. So we've got all that kind of stuff. And then of course we have the other one that I was hoping would load. Okay, it's still not wanting to load in. Can I just click? Okay, there we go. No, that's the same thing. What the hell? Excuse me. Apparently, they have dead links for displacement mapping. But whatever. Let's take a look at the new ones that we've got going on. So now we're taking a look at light and shadows, global illumination, contact shadows, shadows on effects. I briefly just scrolled through this, and there looks to be a lot to take a look at here. So we've got global illumination. So it says on the top, first of all, let's just say what today's edition of our dev blog will discuss how the updated Dagger Engine 5.0 render. Is that a new map? No, that's not. That's the abandoned factory. Is it? Wait, is it? Is that abandoned factory? Let me check the comments because it looks like abandoned factory, but without the giant like canisters sitting here. Because this look, this is the building that you drive up next to. Okay, you know what? It's got to be abandoned factory, but I must be missing something. Let's see what they say in the comments. Maybe somebody else pointed it out. Okay, nobody pointed out. Maybe somebody else can point out to me where this location is on that map. I don't know. It's going to add volume to the world. It's all about light and shades. We've got global illumination coming, shadows on effects, and contact shadows. Now you might not see a lot of difference here just in these in this visual. At least I couldn't. Like here I couldn't see anything. I couldn't really notice much here. This one I didn't really know what I was looking for because I'm dumb. Well, we've got these sliders down here, so I'm assuming that's where it's going to go. So first of all, we're going to talk about global illumination. So let's see what global illumination is all about. Several lighting and shading algorithms are used when rendering each frame in War Thunder. In the updated Dagger Engine 5.0 render, we are improving the lighting model with real-time global illumination. Global illumination is the common term for lighting algorithms. This includes not only direct illumination, but also reflected and scattered light from surfaces and area lights, such as sky and clouds. Our game will have shadows and objects cast from ambient illumination and the sky, making the visuals more volumetric and detailed in shadows. Global illumination will also introduce light reflected from other objects and the environment. All of it will be implemented in real time for large-scale locations. The average War Thunder location is 32 by 32 kilometers for destructible and dynamic objects. Ooh. Like other upgrades to the game's visuals, global illumination will be available as an option in the graphics settings menu and will be enabled by default for high graphical settings, so you can turn it off if you don't want it. Global illumination is a complex mix of algorithms, a very difficult and high technology task. It's enough to say that at the moment there is no game or game engine that has fully fledged dynamic GI for large scale locations. That's the second time I think Gaijin said that they're basically the first people to ever do it. I don't know how much I believe that. It doesn't mean anything because it still looks beautiful. I keep having a problem with algorithms. Where the objects are supposed to be static or require preliminary calculations won't work in War Thunder. Dozens of large-scale locations will require excessive memory and hard drive space, while destructible environment, speaking of hard drive, environment affects the whole geometry very significantly. That is why some of algorithms and improvements will perhaps become available after switching on some personal settings after update 1.77 is released. Meanwhile, a general list of changes is already available. So here we can see this, apparently this global illumination. So it is off currently. This is what it looks like in the game right now. Not bad looking. The shadows look a little edgy. They look a little, it's meh. You can see, you can clearly see where the shade is and where the non-shade is. And by the way, I can see that that building is where those big canisters were. I just thought the canisters were over further. I thought you drove right next to them. Who knows? And then this is what it's going to look like. Far better. It's very, very minor. Of course, you can see these puddles and stuff, but it's very minor. If you look, like the edges are still very straight where the shade is, but you can see that it's working off of each other. You can see that the sunlight is still penetrating, like for example, the ceiling here. Absolutely nothing, just straight up shade. Now you can see that it's going to look far more realistic and dynamic. It's such a minor change, but it's one of those things where it's very minor, but it's big at the same time. Let's have a look at what the next thing is. See the difference in shadow rendering and visual perception of the volume with the new Dagger Engine 5.0 shadowing algorithm. So it looks like here they give us what it's going to look like. It looks like they took texture, like colors and textures, kind of off, or at least colors off of the map here. And then they have them turned on down here so that we can actually look at how it affects. Yeah, so you can basically see, I mean, it looks far better. It almost looks more vibrant than before. I mean, because before it was just straight up gray and dark whenever there was a shadow, and now everything's work, like they said, everything's working off of each other to form better and more realistic and dynamic lighting. So, again, very minor difference, but still just enough of a difference to say, wow, that's very nice looking. And you can see the it looks like we've got the displacement mapping working down here. If you look closely, you can see that the sand actually rises up some of the little dust clouds kind of rise up. That's kind of neat. All right, now we've got shadows on effects. So I'm curious, let's turn this off so that we don't see any of the new stuff yet. Effects are often separate from the rest of the photorealistic rendering, as most effects are simplified versions of much more complex processes like smoke and fire. That's why the effects render is usually a separate process. In the Dagger Engine 5.0, we have calculated the shading of effects by environmental objects such as exhaust fumes or clouds of smoke from a burning tank, making them look more three-dimensional and natural on the final image. All right, so here it is off. This is what it looks like currently in the game. And here it is on. All right, I see. Okay, so basically, like the dust and dirt being thrown up, and like the exhaust, and I guess smoke as well, is going to look. I mean, they say it looks more three-dimensional. To me, it just looks more transparent. Like you can tell it's there, but you can still see all the detail behind it. It's not as if it's its own texture out floating in the world, which I guess is the whole point. Very minor, and again, though, it's going to make a huge difference. Whether that's for good or for bad, that's up to you to decide. I don't know. I kind of liked this. I kind of liked the change of this, but as for the exhaust, I don't know. I always liked having the big puffs of white. Hello? Oh God, I thought my computer was breaking. I kind of like the big poofs of white smoke that come throwing off here. Oh God, it's doing it again, dude. Oh, the internet's breaking. Okay, quickly move on. We got to get this video finished before everything breaks. Turn this off, and now we've got contact shadows. In our new Dagger Engine 5.0 graphics engine to be introduced in War Thunder 1.77, we're presenting an oh god algorithm for creating contact shadows, which make the image more realistic and give depth to maps. Technically, the algorithm for drawing contact shadows relies, in fact, on rendering each frame. Every pixel in the image undergoes ray tracing for a short distance toward the source of light. The tracing takes place through other objects already drawn on the screen. If an obstacle appears in the ray's path, an additional shadow is created. Changes in the grass will be particularly noticeable. Grass in the game could previously take shading from other objects, but couldn't give off shadows itself. The technology of contact shadows not only allows grass to give off its own shadow on the ground, but also give shade to other grass. As a result, grassy meadows and fields will now look deeper and more realistic, both up close and at a distance. Apart from grass, the technology of contact shadows provides a means to create great depth in all objects far away from the player. For example, window frames, rivets in on vehicles, and other objects receive visually more correct sub-pixel shading, in contrast to classic shading methods in which shadows at great distances are drawn only on large objects. So here it is off, looks like Lego, and here it is on, looks like painted Lego. I definitely can see what they're talking about here. I mean, the grass, yeah, I can see the grass effect. In fact, I think there's actually a little bit more down here. Yeah, here's some more. This might give us a better. Like, this is what it looks like now. Very good looking, in my opinion. Looks very nice. But, dude, but now it's going to look like this. The grass is just going to look a lot better. I guess, yeah, when it comes to the structures, I can see the changes, but it looks like a majority of the changes come to the grass itself, which definitely does. That is definitely an improvement. And that seems to be everything. So there you go, guys. That's our fourth look at upcoming changes to the Dagger engine. I thought the only thing that was coming was temporal anti-aliasing. Then they plopped out another one. Then they plopped out another one. And now they've got another one. So there's a whole bunch coming. Just to give you a quick reminder on all the Dagger engine 5.0 changes that are coming, light and shadows are being completely reworked. And then down here you can see temporal anti-aliasing, so the game's going to look a little bit smoother. It is also coming with displacement mapping, so the ground's going to look a little bit more three-dimensional. Mud and puddles are coming to the game. Weather and environment are getting reworked. Rain looks far better. Fog looks far better. Clouds and sun are now very dynamic. They actually move, so that's good. And as for vehicles, well, we've got the Leopard 2K, the Challenger 1, the LA-200, the Magak 3, I believe is how people told me to pronounce that, or Magak, I don't know, it's either Magak or Magak 3, which is a premium, as well as, no, that's the only premium actually listed on here, isn't it? Well, shoot, where's the other one? There's also an AMX-30 pre-order pack coming, and then a British MB5 premium pre-order pack, which for some reason they don't list here. So, going to keep an eye on that that dev blog stuff here on the website, and I'm going to get this video uploaded as quickly as possible, and I don't know, see what's going to happen. Yeah. Fun.